Big up, graduates. Big up on a nice, clean self. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Big up, graduates. Big up on a nice, clean self. Hi, Virginia. What's up, sis? What's poppin'? What's goin'? Good morning, Annetta. Good morning. A blessed day to you, my love. A blessed day to you. Morning, Cherie, sweetie pie. How you doing, girl? How you doing, hon? How is everybody doing? What a way, teacher Katie, about the place. I'm gonna put on my glue, sis. I don't want to miss anything. What a way, my day, all over the place. All right. I'm going to say this. I don't come to stay long because I have things to do. I need to go and do my nails. I have a bag of things to go sort out. You understand? So this is a very short and sharp live. Particularly for those at the back. Particularly for those at the very back. Morning, Dawn. Morning, 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 sis. Particularly for those at the back of the class. This is what this life is for. You know, when you speak from a place of ignorance, you leave no doubt to those who are listening that you are in fact dense. Sometimes when you don't know anything, you feel kibba your tongue, kibba your mouth, and just listen and observe. When you run out, like you think you know, and you don't know sod all, you look like a clown. But apart from that, you also look a little bit eggs up and a little bit too Mickey's. Right? Little bit too Mickey's. Thank you, Pinky. Big up yourself. One thing you must know about head teacher K is she does not speak out of her ass. And I'm very blunt, unfortunately, for some. Some people can't take it, but I am. Because honesty comes with bluntness sometimes. I don't speak out of my backside. And if I say something and I'm representing myself, I'm not talking about if you see me post something, I'm a comment on it, or I'm talking about what's going on in terms of what's happened on social media. I'm saying when head teacher K step out and speak for herself, she has done the research. I'm not an irresponsible blogger, unlike some of you lot out there. When I come out, I don't want to mislead my followers. I want them to have good information, quality information, reliable information. Okay? So you blind binoculars over there, because there's no observant TV going on, who insist on getting involved in things that don't concern you, let me make something very clear to you. Okay? Anything that you consider nonsense is whatever you spewed on your platform last night. Because you have no clue what is going on. You are an empty barrel making a lot of noise. You have the audacity to think that you can splice my video and talk about, oh, nonsense and rubbish. Listen, have several seats. Several seats. There are many things that I can say, but I am holding it. I want you to understand that I am holding it. Many things that I can say. What I have said is factual. Thank you very much, Anetta. Thank you so much, Pinky. I don't just take hearsay things that are brought to me without doing due diligence and researching the information to say, well, something can't really go so. What do you think? You think that you're dealing with some kind of comeuppance here? Some little hurry come up? Don't even try it. Because you see, you and I, blind binoculars, we are not on the same level. Not in the same caliber in any way, shape, or form. So don't confuse yourself. I said what I said, and what I said was factual. You are there talking about, oh, I've had this experience. This is what I've done. I've never heard of the Canadian embassy to do this. Be quiet. Do you think this situation was a situation where you were dealing with a typical visa application? Do you know what the protocols are when something is suspected in terms of fraud where the Canadian embassy is concerned? Have you read the policies and the procedures of the Canadian embassy when it comes to investigating what they consider to be fraudulent visa activities? You're talking out of your backside. And you're blowing a lot of hot air. The person that I spoke with that actually reached out to me, because I don't go digging for stuff, it landed on my lap. The person I spoke with, who I also know and trust, is a very primary source of information. And I have come here to tell people that the IAAA awards received a hell of a fight. And instead of you rallying around to support, to see if we can get to the bottom of this, you are trying to discredit what is fact. What is your agenda? Whatever personal issue you have with me, you know, keep that to yourself, because I couldn't care less. I'm not looking enough in front of you. I don't respect you. I mean, I'm telling you that now, here and now, on the loud, brawling. Anybody whose mouth is mixed up in our kind of behind the back DM nonsense and talking about revenge porn, me and them will never sit at the same table. So you see, if you know what is good for you, blind binoculars over there, stay in your lane. Stay in your lane. Leave the people with a certain iota of ethics and morals and a certain iota of intellect to just do what we are doing. Because you don't have a clue what takes place. You don't know. So stay over there. You notice I may not come over there. If somebody never tell me, say, you're over there, play my video, I wouldn't reach because I don't look at you. I don't. What I've heard is enough. Right? Go and try and push your charity money on somebody else. Make them neglect it and say them don't want it now. Huh? Come out of my soup, Annette. Because if I say something, I say it with my full chest. That lady, Miss Princess, received a hell of a fight. A hell of a fight. And it's a fight on a different level. And I'm trying to let people know that all these little nitpicks that's going on between small-time bloggers and big platforms is not the meat of the matter. And that people really should be focusing on the likeliest suspect. You think it's just one letter was written? I spoke of the one with the most impact. And I'm not going to say anything else. But trust and believe, there is a lot more that can be said, and there's a lot more knowledge behind this face and this voice. Instead of you coming out and saying, listen, whatever took place as a result of this woman trying to do something great for the community of Jamaica is wrong, you're over there throwing bitchy shades. And I tell you, you know, I don't play bitchy games, you know. I stepped you in real life. Yeah. So if that's what you want, in your majesty's voice, let's canter. I said what I said, and what I said is factual. That is what took place. And as you can see, clearly from the Canadian Embassy's own website, based in Jamaica, the Jamaican version of the page. Many times, and it is normal practice, interviews take place where visa applications need to be verified. And that interview that took place wasn't even really an interview. It was an interrogation. Okay? And yes, the content of the letter was discussed with the person that was there. And yes, there was more than one letter, but that one was damaging. And yes, they did ask, who is 99? They asked about other people too. But I'm going to leave it there. But don't try and press my buttons. If you're going to discredit something, go and discredit the junk of them. We're busy. I try to tear down Miss Princess situation. Go and busy yourself doing something productive. If you're going to be a social media scavenger to try and find content to discuss it with sense. And don't discuss it blindly. Oh, and a little bit of etiquette for you. If you are going to reach out to somebody's content within your own community, an intelligent thing to do is to actually contact them to say, can I use your video? I want to discuss what took place. That would be wise. Because anything else that happens afterwards, because you've decided to step out of line, blinds binoculars, will be fully your own responsibility. Some are on a two little bit of Mickey's and a little bit of enough. Notice I sit down on my page and I say what I have to say. You never see me all over the place, I say it. My page, my space. But you stepped into my garden thinking that you could just pick roses without asking. Dream on. Keep yourself east while I keep myself west. I am focusing on the real issues that are taking place here. With very good knowledge. And if I choose to say allegedly, that's because I was not sat at the table during the investigation. The interrogation, rather. So that is a sensible thing to do. Do not pass your place with me. Because we are not shoulder to shoulder rubbing at all. We are not on the same level and never will be. Don't misunderstand this head teacher, Kay. Because I am not friendly when it comes to people who take the mick. And for those of you who are not British, that means, you know, be rude. Don't. Everything that I said is factual. And you have no clue. So stop blowing hot air out of your backside. Go do your research before you approach this table. Money, they don't know who they're playing with. And this is the thing. They always think, and this is what I've always noticed, you know. Those who have a presence that's apparently established and they see somebody who's a newcomer, they feel like they can just jump on you and do whatever the hell they want to do. Or they think that you're a bit of a weak fence. You see the stuff them when I post? Trust me, if me never identify with some of them, I wouldn't post it. Do not take me lightly. You understand me? Don't do it. That's why I don't mess with people. I have a very small, select few who I definitely respect and like. You understand? And you see, when I definitely respect or I like you, I would not hesitate to say it on your platform. Because I see in you something that I admire, I will not hesitate to say it. If I don't take tea with you, I'm not going to hesitate to say it either. But it doesn't mean that I can't see stuff in you that are good, that is good, or stuff in you that's not. I will see both. Because I don't allow my emotions to blind me. Okay? So you, there's nothing unique coming on from over there. You are giving common approach. Think carefully before you use my content again. This is my final warning. Because if you are not going to do so objectively and with respect, I'm going to come for you. Yes? I have no problem with people who share my content. No problem with it once they do it appropriately. There is no misappropriation. There is no people trying to rip me apart, because I will not stand for that. And then you use my content. Are you crazy? You can talk and say whatever the hell you want to say. But you use my content and then you want to be rude? Yeah, you must say lick your head. You must say lick your head. Or were you dropped on it? Understand yourself. Anyway, mega stop misbehave myself. Hope you guys are great and having a good day. Hope you're having a good day. Let me check out some of these comments. I really like your page. I just started following you. It actually seems to be positive and informative. I love it. Thank you, D. Big up yourself. I try to be, but you know, there's always some, you know, little, well, always I try get you in that way. You know what I'm saying? Throwing their little slyness, thinking that their vocabulary can pass over everybody's head. But listen, this is not the place for it, because this classroom is full of papier brainy people. So no bother with it. You understand me? We love grassroots. We love the intellectual. And we love the in-between over here. So everybody have space to express themselves. I don't feel no way about it. We don't look down upon nobody around here. But let me tell you this. If you step to it in a head teacher care class, just know, say, we are going to done you. You understand? We are going to done you. And we can done you on every level, right? But we try to keep it positive, keep it lighthearted, enjoy yourself, enjoy social media, and we stay in our lane. Yeah, we do. We stay in our lane over here. And even my ardent followers, no matter where they are, I see them about the place, them now misbehave, them just enjoy themselves and I enjoy social media. But some of you out there feel like, say, you can come and take people's content and then tear them down in a certain kind of way and get away with it. Don't do that. Don't do that. This is not still videos that you're yanking off from way over so and so over TikTok. Yeah? When it comes to bloggers, there is a code of conduct. And you see, if you skip you skip that code of conduct and think that you can surpass it, then anything reach you. You understand me? Anything reach you. Same way, Salinda. You understand me? Right? I don't call you. Do not come running. But if you call me, I'll be there. You understand me? Y'all are too messy. And for somebody who have already gone down with one whole bunch of baga with people, I call your name all about and I talk about how you're deceptive and you betray this person and that person. I threaten to send revenge porn all about the place. Keep your skin quiet and do what you do over your platform and don't look in my direction at all. Do not avoid me. That me, I tell you. Avoid me. Anyway. Blessed people. Linda, you're late. You have to go back up. Have yourselves a wonderful day. I'm going to go do my nails now and do what I have to do in my house. All right? And a big up on yourself. It's a rain over here. So me can't go outside again today. And I really need to go do my walking, guys. I am so behind. But I'm going to try and do something. Lift some weights. Do whatever in the house today. Because it's all about keeping fit and healthy for the summer. Be blessed. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.